Well, you all settled in? Right, we can begin.
And this is the Star Child skull that I'm holding. This skull is an amazing artifact that was found in about 1930. It is a bone skull, real true bone skull, but all the bone in it is half as thick as normal, weighs half as much, and yet incredibly is two or three times as hard. So that in and of itself is unique, but as you can see, physiologically, it is unlike any human skull in all of its parts. For example, it's missing the knot at the back of the head that we all have called the Inion, completely missing it. Very flat back here, but convoluted, so it wasn't cradle boarded. Its neck is about half the size of a human's neck. Its cheek muscles, the muscles that hold its cheekbones together, are about half the size. Normal human would be up here, about half the size. It had a very, very small lower face, very shallow eye sockets, eyes that would be placed in the middle of the nose and bulging off rather than at the top of the nose. In every way you can think of, this skull is not human in either its design or in its DNA. When we tried to recover its DNA, we found that its mitochondrial DNA recovered very easily, meaning that its mother is human, but its nuclear DNA, which contains the DNA of its mother and its father, was not able to be recovered in six attempts. So that tells us its DNA, its nuclear DNA, is not entirely human. So we think we have in this skull the first bona fide, provable evidence of life from beyond Earth. Of life from beyond Earth.
In the 1970s, the skeptical magazine Fortean Times claimed a man had faked an archaeological artifact which had supposedly been discovered in Nepal. The famous Lolladoff plate is meant to be nearly 9,000 years old and shows a disc-shaped craft with a small alien-type creature standing beside it. This controversial item is either a fake or one of the most obvious warnings from the past that aliens have visited the Himalayas.
Sounds like something out of a movie. UFO encounters here on Earth.
But that's exactly what firefighters are now training for.
Only on ABC 15, Christopher Sine shows us the disaster guide you'll be talking about.
Sightings like the Phoenix Lights have generated questions and made believers out of skeptics. In this 600-page guide, may lend credibility to UFOs. It's the Fire Officer's Guide to Disaster Control and said to be found in firehouses across the U.S. The book covers everything from fires to floods, but it's chapter 13 that takes an unusual twist in firefighting techniques titled Enemy Attack and UFO Potential.
It would not be remiss to give some thought to the part that fire departments might play in the event of the unexpected arrival of UFOs in their communities.
The book, written by two retired firefighters, addresses what first responders could encounter.
You may have engine trouble upon approaching the scene, and radio contact could be lost with your dispatcher. If at night your headlight could go out, the city could be blacked out, and your portable generators may malfunction.
No, this took me by surprise.
Believers like Jim Mann see the book as an opportunity.
This is a real phenomena that we should deal with. We should deal with seriously.
So, is it for training purposes, or is it enough to warrant a UFO education red alert?
This is something that could really happen in our lifetime.
It even asks, how do you treat injured aliens? Are first responders aware of the potential physical injuries?
Some fire chiefs have little confidence in disaster plans, especially those dealing with UFOs or enemy attack.
We contacted several fire agencies regarding this book, and some even called us. However, not one admitted to using it for training, although some are aware it exists.
Yeah, you know what, Chris? It just shows you that serious, professional people are starting to take this whole subject of UFOs and ET, they're starting to take this seriously.
Jim Mann investigates sightings and encounters for the mutual UFO network known as MUFON.
This is a real threat to this planet.
MUFON has its own investigative guide seen here publicly for the first time.
And I don't think we're crackpots. I think that we're just people that want to be aware of what's going on. We don't know where we came from. We don't know where we're going.
This is a photo of the Altiplano in Bolivia. Archaeologists and researchers found out that at least before 4,000 years there was having a very big impact in Argentina, and the shockwave of this big impact destroyed many stone buildings in the Altiplano of Bolivia. They found skeletons with a size of 2.6 meters. And the picture on the top shows you the skull of one of these skeletons, and it looks like it is deformed, but definitely these skulls are not deformed. They are natural style, like an egg. On this photo you see how strong the jaw of those skulls were. This is a front view, and the most interesting photo is this one, because you can see that the top of the skull does not have the three plates which we have as Homo sapiens, and that shows us that these skeletons are not Homo sapiens. What we might be able is doing a DNA check and an age dating on these skeletons, because we are very much wondering what kind of humans did exist long time ago and how long ago.
That's what I keep asking myself. What's it all about? Know what I mean?
Thank you.